Hi, it's me, Tariq Akhtar Ansari. Let me give you the quick demo which I'm going to do in this video. So you can see here one registration form. For designing this registration form, I have taken one panel and I have divided that panel into three different parts: heading, body and footer. You can see the information in heading and footer as well. You can see the copyright information. In the body, I have taken one form, and here you can see if I'm clicking on first name, this is label, then first name text box getting focused. Only one of that options I can select, either male, female or others. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can design this type of form.
Subscribe Technical Babaji channel and press the bell icon to get the latest video updates.
So for designing this, I have used bootstrap.css file. So you can download from the official website. I will give the link below in the description. So you can follow this link to download bootstrap.css. Now in my localhost, I'm creating one folder, test. Inside that folder, I'm creating one more folder, CSS. Inside CSS, I'll paste bootstrap.css file. So now I will suggest you to use Sublime Text for the coding. Okay, now create one file with dot extension of HTML. Inside the test folder, here I'm giving name index.html. In Sublime Text, if you'll write h, it will give you the prediction HTML. If you'll hit the enter button, it automatically will generate the HTML code. Here I'm choosing title registration page. Now we need to link this HTML form with CSS, bootstrap.css. Inside CSS folder, I have bootstrap.css file. Now inside the body, I'm taking one more div, class as a container. This is a bootstrap class. Inside this container, I'll take one row, div, class as a row. Inside this row, I'll take one panel, div, class, panel primary. So here I'm taking two classes. So now I'll divide this panel into three different parts: class, panel heading. This is heading. Now I'll take another div, class, panel body. I'm taking two class again here. Now one more div, class, panel footer. Now I'm just giving a message. This is body, this is footer. Now let's run it and check how it's looking. So you can see this is not looking so good. Now let me remove the panel from body and footer, not from the main div, from body, remove this panel class and from footer as well. Now save it and runs once again. Now you can see it's looking good. Now I want to reduce the width of this panel. So in row class, I'll take one more class called -md-6 and one more class called -md-offset-3. So now you can see the difference. So it's coming half and in center. Let me explain you one more time. So what will happen if I will remove the call md-offset-3? So now you can see it's coming, but it's coming from the left side. So we have to add this so that we can leave three row from the left hand side. Now inside the heading, I'm taking h1 tag, registration form. Okay, in footer, I need copyright symbol. For that, use and copy semicolon. Okay, and space, I'm writing here Technical Babaji. And one more thing, we want it should come in right side. So I'll use text hyphen right. So it's not coming what I want. So something I did mistake, I think. Oh, so here I have to remove the N and save it again and run this. Now you can see it's coming, but I need the size should be small. So I will use the small tag. Inside this I will paste and save it. Now I need the heading should be in center, then I have to use the class text center. Now see the difference. Now I'll create the form inside the body. So remove this and create form using form tag. Inside the form we need one div, and the class of this div will be form group. Okay, and inside this I'll take one label and one input box. Inside the label I'm writing first name, and input box type should be text. We don't require name right now. Take one more class, form control. Okay, now save it and check. So now if I'm clicking on label, my focus is not coming on input box. If you want that, then take one attribute for inside the label and define the ID. Before defining ID, we have to create the ID of text box. Here I'm creating first name and defining that ID here, first name, save it, run it. Now see the difference. When I'm clicking on label, my focus is coming to input box. Okay, now just copy this and paste it again here two times. For the last name, type last name and use Control D in Sublime Text for multiple select, and just write last name in one time. Okay, now here I need the email. Again use Control D two times and type email for multiple changes. Now see the output. So okay, now I need gender option in my form. For that I'm copying this again, copy this and paste here, change this to gender. For the gender I need label. Inside that label I need one input, type should be radio, and here I'm taking name as gender, and outside of that input box I'm writing male. Okay, now if I will click on male, radio button should be clicked. For that I need for attribute for label and define ID inside the input. I'm defining male and pass here in for attribute male, that ID of input box. Okay, now I need a class. Radio inline. Okay, now just see here. Okay, it's coming in the same line. I need in the next line. For that you can take one div, it will automatically will come in the next line. Paste it here. Now see the difference, it's coming on next line. Now I need female and others option, so just copy this and paste two times again and change the label name to female and their ID as well, female. For others and label as well. Okay, name should be same for all the three radio button. Okay, here I did the mistake, right here male and change this male to female. Okay, fine. And others, just save it and run. Now you can see all three options is coming. Now I need gender should come before the email, so just copy this div and cut from here and paste it before that email div. Okay, now copy the email and paste two times again for the password and for phone number. Password and use Ctrl D option for multiple select and change for an ID at a time. And phone number. Again, do the Ctrl D. I'm taking number, ID. Okay. Now see, everything is coming. The final thing, we need a button. For that, outside of the div, you can take input, type as submit, and we don't require name. We need a class button, btn primary, so it will come in blue and white combination. And we need a value. If you will not give the value, by default it will come submit. Okay. So now that's it in this video. Hope you will like this video and subscribe my channel. Thank you guys for